12 of Ilia's playing fields have been put under review, and many people are worried that the authority are planning to sell them off, and the school children of London will lose their sporting heritage. However, John O'Malley says Ilia is being responsible.
A year ago, we had 12 major playing fields that were no longer being used by London children. We've done everything we can in the last year to preserve those playing fields for inner London children with the borough councils and with the sporting organisations. We think we've got 11 of them sorted out. This is one that no borough council wants.
This leaves the Raynes Park ground with a dubious future. Due to go on the market for millions of pounds, that sort of price will only attract property developers.
As a local authority, we have an obligation to, when we dispose of anything, to sell at the highest price. We can only discount it if we can honestly justify the discount for the benefit of the people we serve, which is the school children of Inner London. In this case, we cannot find a reason for suggesting a discount, and for that reason, we are going to put the playing field on the market and get the price that we think it will get.
Basically, Jim Thorpe from the Sports Council says sports facilities should not be sold off.
The loss of such a strategically valuable site as Raynes Park is very serious. The Sports Council is ultimately in the business of trying to promote and develop participation in sport, and if the facility base on which we can build that participation is constantly being cut away from us, then I think there's a serious loss to sport in general in London.
While the other 11 playing fields probably will be saved, without government intervention, this playing field will turn into a whole development of houses. Scarlett Maguire at Raynes Park Playing Fields for Thames News.